For the beam shown below with constant E of 200 gigapascals by conjugate beam method, determine the slopes just to the left and just to the right of B and the deflection at B. So here is the given figure. So the simply supported portion of the beam segment would be BCD. So let's consider beam BCD first. Let's assume reaction at C as upward. Then let's sum up moment about B equals 0. So moment B equals 0, it is R sub C times 4 minus 30 times 6. So R sub C is equal to 45 kilonewtons. So if R sub C is 45 kilonewtons and we have 30 kilonewtons here, so the shear just to the right of B should also be 15 kilonewtons downward. So shear B plus 30 equals 45. So this should be 15 kilonewtons, then by action-reaction principle, 15 kilonewtons just to the left. So let's select A and C as our moment centers for this case. But before that, take note that segment AB of the beam has moment of inertia of 800 times 10 to the 6, while BCD is 600 times 10 to the 6. So let's consider I of AB as 1, as I only, 800 times 10 to the 6. So therefore, 600 divided by 800, I BCD should be 0.75 of I. So 0.75 of, or 3/4 of I AB. So therefore, EI, 200,000 megapascals times 800 times 10 to the 6, or 200 times 10 to the 6 times I, 800 times 10 to the 6 divided by 1,000 to the 4th, to convert it to kilonewton meter square is 160,000 kilonewton meter square. So remember the technique for theta and for slopes. So we just divide for theta, for slopes, and for deflection. For slopes, we divide everything by EI, but for deflection, we just divide by 160 to convert it to millimeters automatic. So let's now draw the conjugate beam. So this is the conjugate beam, fixed becomes free. This is an interior pin, interior hinge at C, then fixed at D. Remember the transformation of real beam to conjugate beam. Then since this is 15 times 6 is 90 over EI, then the moment of this load here about this left end, A, 36 times 6 times 3, is equal to that second degree, 648 over EI. Then 15, let's make C also as moment center. 15 times 4 is 60, divided by EI, where I is 0.75 of I. So that makes it 60 divided by 0.75 is 80 over EI. And of course, 30 times 2 is 60 divided by 0.75, so it's also 80 over EI. So let's consider first AB. That's the positive slope at B just to the left, positive slope at B just to the right, because this is an interior pin, so the slope just to the left and just to the right would be different, unless it is an interior hinge where slopes just to the left and just to the right would be the same. And the deflection or moment just to the left or just to the right of the pin is the same. So positive direction is counterclockwise, the right just to the left of pin, and just to the right is clockwise. So remember the sign convention. So this is upward, positive area, and this is downward. So to solve for theta B left, we just apply summation forces Y equals 0 for portion A to just to the left of B. So we have 1 half or 0.5 of 6 times 90 over EI, then minus theta B left, then minus this area, which is 1 third of 6 times 648 over EI, equals 0. So from there, we can now solve theta B left, 3 times 90 minus 2 times 648. Theta B left is equal to negative 1026 over EI. So theta B left divided by 160,000 in radians is negative 1026 over 160,000. Then theta B left is equal to negative 6.4125 times 10 to the negative 3 radians. Likewise, summation moment, considering again AB, at B, just to the left, counterclockwise positive. So delta B plus 1 third of 6 times 648 over EI. If this is 1 fourth of 6, then this is 3 fourths or 0.75 of 6. Remember. Then minus 1 half or 0.5 of 6 times 90 over EI, then this distance is 2 thirds of 6, which is 4 meters, equals 0. So delta B can now be computed. It is equal to negative 4752 over EI. So the technique, you just divide it by 160 to make it mm from our previous examples and from our experience. So delta B is equal to negative 29.7 mm. Finally, for theta B right, we apply first the slope at C, positive slope. And so that theta C will not be involved, so this is downward. We simply sum up moment about C, considering BC, because theta B right is known, is unknown, but delta B is known, and so that theta C will not be involved. So summation moment C equals 0, considering BC, we have theta B right times 4, then plus delta B, which is negative 4752 over EI, then minus 1 half or 0.5 of 4 times 80 over EI, moment arm 1 third of 4 or 4 thirds, equals 0. So from there, we can solve theta B right equals 3724 over 3 EI divided by 160,000 in radians. So 3724 over 3 times 160,000. So theta B right is equal to 7.758 times 10 to the negative 3 radians. So that's it for this problem.